When I'm starting the new day, with my worries far away, I like blue skies and new sights, so many words to say. It's the right time. It's the right time. Loops, dots, and lines, I feel just fine. Let's write the time away. It's the right time.
Hi, boys and girls. How are you today? Today we're going to try something a little bit different. What's all that noise? Bob, what are you doing?
Oh, nothing.
Bob, you're doing something. We can all hear it. Are those cursive numerals?
Yep. I just wanted to see how they stack up.
Oh, Bob. Why don't we write cursive numerals or numbers one at a time?
That's a good idea, too.
First, let's take a look at manuscript numbers. And now, cursive numbers.
The cursive numbers look pretty similar to the manuscript numbers, don't they?
What do you see as the biggest difference between the two numbers? The cursive numbers have a forward slant to them. The manuscript numbers are vertical, more up and down. How are the cursive and manuscript numbers the same? They're all tall numbers, just like tall letters. Both set of numbers always reach the top line and rest on the baseline. Now, are you ready to write? If you are, then your desk should be clear except for paper, pencil, and your It's the Right Time folder. Okay, Bob, let's start with the number one and the number two.
One and two, now let's learn something new.
Number one is the slant from the top line to the baseline. The number two needs a little more imagination. There's a slight slant that checks back up to the top line with a curve forward, then slant or pull down to the baseline. Now go to the right with a small curve above the baseline. It's called the curve right.
Thanks, Bob. You and I will now write these two numbers. Think of preparing to write cursive numbers as the same as writing letters. Make sure your paper's turned correctly. We'll write the number one together three times. The one simply pulls down from the top to the bottom. Two more, top line, baseline. And again. Now let's write the number two. It starts with a little slant, then back up to the top line, curve, pull to the baseline, and curve to the right. Let's write two more. Slant, curve, pull, and curve right. That slant looks a little like a check. And slant, curve, pull, and curve right. Remember, all the numbers are tall. If the little slant at the top goes above the top line, that's all right. Bob, let's move on to numbers three and four.
Three and four, we're gonna write some more.
Three starts with the same little slant at the top, then curve down to the midline, and another curve down to the baseline, and finish. Four starts with a slant to just below the midline, then the slide right across the midline. Lift your pencil and slant or pull down from the top line to the baseline.
All right, pick up your pencil and let's write the number three. There's the little slant. Now touch the top line and curve forward to the midline, then another curve down to the baseline and finish. Okay, let's write two more. Slant, curve, curve again, and finish. Slant, curve, curve, and finish. Very good. Now, with the number four, you slant down from the top line to just below the midline, and then slide over to the midline. Lift your pencil and slant from the top line to the baseline. two more times. Slant, slide, lift, and slant. And your second slant is just like writing the number one. Well, how are you doing? Let's write five and six, and you're more than halfway there.
Five and six, some loops will do the trick.
Five starts at the top line, with the slant to the midline, then a big curve to the baseline, and finish. But wait! You still have to lift your pencil and connect the five at the top line and slide right. Number six is fun because it's a big curve down from the top line to the baseline, then a loop below the midline.
We're going to write the number five three times. Here we go. Pull down to the midline, now a big curve down and finish further out. Lift your pencil and connect the five with a slide to the right. Let's write two more together. Pull, big curve, lift, and slide right. And one more. Pull, big curve, lift, and slide right. Let's write the number six. From the top line, curve down, loop, and close. And two more. Curve down, loop, and close. Make sure the loop is below the midline. Again, curve down, loop, and close.
I think this would be a good time to practice our math. Pencil up and write with me. One plus two equals three. Make sure there's a curve right at the end of two. Okay, here's another. Four plus one equals five. Don't forget, for the number five, you have to lift your pencil and slide right to finish it off. And six minus four equals two. The six loops and closes without touching the midline. With the number four, you have to lift your pencil and slant down as if you were writing the number one.
Well, we've practiced numbers one through six, so that means there's only four more to go. Okay, relax your fingers to get the tension out, sit up nice and straight, and let's watch Bob write the numbers seven and eight.
Seven and eight, more numbers, I can't wait.
The number seven has a new stroke, and it's called the double curve. After the small slant at the top line, the double curve makes its way along the top line, then slant down to the baseline. The number eight is a series of curves and finishes with a straight line or a slant up. Starting just below the top line, you curve back and down to the baseline, then curve back and slant up. Make sure you close the eight.
Let's first practice the slant double curve a couple times before you write the number seven. The slant is just like the numbers two and three, where starting just above the top line is okay. After the slant, double curve across the top line like this. The double curve is simply a wavy line. Write the slant double curve three times with me. Slant and double curve. Stay close to the top line. Again, slant and double curve. And one more. Slant and double curve. The rest of the number seven is easy. A pull down to the baseline. Let's write three sevens. Slant, double curve, and pull. Again, slant, double curve, and pull. Don't lift your pencil. Remember, top line to baseline. The number eight starts below the top line, then curve. Touch the top line, another curve to the baseline, curve up, then straight up to the top line. That's called the slant up. Normally, when we slant, it's a pull down, but in this case, we slant up. Be sure to close the number eight. Let's write some more eights. Cross the eight near the midline. This number will take some practice to touch all the lines and to close the eight. Curve, curve, curve back, and slant up. Very good. Okay, pencils down. Bob, let's continue with the numbers 9 and 10.
With 9 and 10, you can count all over again.
The 9 starts at the top line with a down curve and undercurves just below the midline and back up to close at the top line. Then it's the straight slant down to the baseline. The last number to practice is 10. You already know half of the number 10. First, it's the 1. That's the slant from the top line to the baseline. Lift your pencil and leave a space. The 0 starts at the top line with the down curve to the baseline. Then undercurve back to the top and close. Remember to make the 0 with a forward slant.
Thanks, Bob. I want you to remember that all the cursive numbers have a forward slant. Okay, let's write the number 9 together. Start the 9 at the top line with a down curve through the midline, then undercurve and close. Then pull down to the baseline. Again, curve down just below the midline and curve back up, then pull to the baseline. One more. Down curve, curve, and pull. Make sure you close the 9. Now, let's move on to the number 10. The 10 starts with a slant for the number 1. Lift your pencil and leave a space. The 0 starts at the top line and curves down and undercurves back up. As you write more 10s, make sure you close the 0. Again, slant, and the 0 is not a perfect circle. It's an oval. Okay, let's do some more math with the numbers. Write across 9 plus 7. Well, how much is that?
I know.
I know you do, Bob. But let's let them write the answer down in cursive numbers. It's 16. Did you touch the top line and the baseline? Did your 6 loop below the midline? All right, here's another one. Write 5 plus 6.
I know the answer, Miss Losey. I'd raise my hand if I had one.
Okay, Bob, put in the answer. The answer is 11, so it's 2 ones. How about 10 minus 2? Then write the answer. Be sure to leave a space when writing 10 or any other number combination like 45, 71, or 101. Come up with your own number combinations. Just remember to keep that forward slant. Bob, are you stacking up those numbers again?
No.
Well, I hope Bob is okay. Do you want to say goodbye, Bob?
Oh, double ouch, double ouch! Bye.
When I'm starting.
He's okay. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
With my worries far away, I like blue skies and new sights. So many words to say. It's the right time. It's the right time. Loops, dots, and lines, I feel just fine. Let's write the time away. It's the right time.